Greetings. In order for Islamic speakers to try and find Mohammed in the Bible, they have to try all kinds of crazy claims. Ahmed Deedat even tried to argue many times that Mohammed is the Holy Spirit. This very same argument can be seen all over YouTube today. Where did Deedat do this, you ask? Specifically, in the context of trying to claim Mohammed is the comforter foretold by Jesus in John 14, 15, and 16, when Jesus says, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost." When Jesus specifically names who the Comforter is, the Holy Ghost, Islamic speakers have to try and get around this simple, absolutely clear declaration by Jesus. Okay, let's play along and imagine Mohammed is the Holy Ghost, where the Greek word ghost is pneuma, which means Mohammed is the Holy Spirit. Let's play along and see what this leads to. Then Matthew 1:20 creates real problems for Islam. I'll apologize in advance for the unusually graphic nature of this argument. But this literally is the mess Deedat makes for Islam when in his error he claims Muhammad is the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost. Matthew 1:20. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost," or Holy Pneuma, meaning Holy Spirit. The New Living Translation says it this way: "For the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit." The International Standard Version says, "Because what has been conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit." God's Word Translation says, "She is pregnant by the Holy Spirit." Young's literal translation says, "For that which in her was begotten is of the Holy Spirit." Do you begin to see the problem Deedat has created? If Deedat is correct, and Mohammed is the Holy Spirit, then Mohammed had sex with Mary, and Mary was not a virgin. In fact, Mohammed is the father of Jesus, even though Mohammed didn't exist for another 600 years. I'm sure all Mohammedans watching this are saying, "No, no, no," about now. But this is the mess Deedat makes when, in his error, in his desperation, he claims Mohammed is the Holy Spirit. You cannot say in one verse, "The Holy Spirit is Mohammed." And when you are embarrassed by this definition, say, "Mohammed is not the Holy Spirit. Mohammed either is or Mohammed is not the Holy Spirit." So what does this prove exactly? It proves that Mohammed is not the Holy Spirit, and Mohammed is not the Comforter Jesus spoke of. If you call yourself Muslim, perhaps you are shocked into seeing just how flawed the error is of claiming Muhammad is the Holy Spirit, the comforter of John 14, 15, and 16. If you call yourself Muslim, perhaps you will begin to ask why Islam is so confused on such simple issues. Why do men like Deedat, Dr. Nike, and others who are Mohammedan apologists, why do they simply have such contradictory definitions? Why are they so inconsistent? Why can't they think these things through like educated, honest men? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, the third member of the Trinity, not Muhammad. Amen.